Hey everybody, Joe Granatelli. Today we're going to talk about our 500-201C, which is the coolant tank cover, and 500-201B, which is our wrinkle black complete tank. These are designed specifically to replace or cover the factory tank on a late model CTS-V, all Cadillac ATS, and all Cadillac CTS to be exact. It doesn't have to be on the V, as well as all the late model Camaros, whether it be the four cylinder turbo, the six cylinder, or the V8, as well as the new ZL1. These tanks work on all those applications. There's another video out there already that we did showing the install on the Camaro. This one is for the Cadillac people that were a little more snobbish. They wanted to actually see us install it on a Cadillac. So why don't you follow along as we do the installation. All right, everybody. So the first thing we're going to do now is we're going to remove the parts that are in the way in order to install this tank. I pre-loosened these, but I'm going to loosen them again. You really need to remove the shock tire brace in order to get to the back radiator cap, as well as there's two caps. So one that you see here, but there's actually a cap on the back side on the bottom down here, which is this chamber is dual chambered, which we'll show you in the next segment. And the way to access the two chambers is the main cap here, but there's also another chamber which has to be viewed when you remove this. I'm not really sure why the factory designed it that way, but nonetheless, what I'm going to do is I'm going to loosen these up. So I'm using a 13 millimeter, and I'm just going to take these off. Have to come around over here. So I made it easy. Take the shock tire brace off. And now that gives us access to the back of the tank. Tank is held on by just one 10 millimeter bolt, nut. So we remove the 10 millimeter nut. That's the only thing holding this tank in is this one nut. It's indexed by a pin here, and there's a pin in the back, which is basically a stud that sticks out. And of course, it goes without being said that you should make sure the engine's not hot when you remove the cap. That just relieves the pressure, obviously, and we're gonna need to take that off to get the tank out. Next thing we're gonna do is we're going to, I'm gonna remove these two clamps, and these are pinch clamps. They're reusable, so just remove the clamp and then just slide the whole slide the clamp down. And the next one is on the back side here, which I'll show you at a later moment because I know it's hard to get the camera down in here. I'm going to loosen this clamp, slide the clamp back. Now I'm just going to use a little pry bar. You could probably pull them off if you want. These things are not on very tight, but I wanted to make sure it was loose. You see how easy that hose came right off? And just kind of keep it above the radiator line. The back one might have a little bit of a drip when you pull it out. I did drain approximately a pint of fluid out of here. Not a lot of fluid in this tank, but so you want to drain a little bit of that fluid out before you pull this hose off. And then you really shouldn't even lose any fluid at all, believe it or not. It's a simple installation. But I can see I'm going to lose a little bit right here. Let me get a rag. So I'm just going to put a little rag down here because there's a little bit loose right here. And then if you can see this right here, this hose is, it has just a little bit of fluid that's right at the top. So you do want to try to keep that up above the radiator line. So I'm gonna put it behind the shock tower right here. And essentially the tank comes straight out now. So it just comes straight up with it. So the next step we're gonna do now is we're gonna go over to the bench, and I'm gonna show you guys on the bench how to fill this tank. You'll notice what's interesting about this one is the bottom tank, which you'll see here. This bottom tank that goes down in here, it was empty already, so the auxiliary coolant recovery tank is not even, had no fluid in it. It should have actually had about that much, and we're going to show you how in a minute, how to get to that. So let's go to the next step. Okay, the first thing you'll notice when we start this job is the discoloration of the stock tank. The stock tank is already, this is 1 year and 2 months old, and it's already turning yellow. So that's important that you see that, because what we're really selling you is a device that makes the car more beautiful and more attractive. You want the outside of the car and the engine compartment to look just as good. And that's essentially what we're doing. So we do offer a cover, which is more economical, you know, about $80, or we offer a complete tank, which is a little more costly, but it'll last you the lifetime of the vehicle, and it really looks great. So let me show you the idiosyncrasies of this part of the application and installation. We can go from there. So I'm gonna put this one to the side because it's essentially a stock tank. This is the tank we took out. Now, as I told you a little earlier in the video, this should have had fluid in it. And you'll see there's a line right here. I don't know if you can zoom in on that or not. But right there, there's actually a fill line, and this fluid should have been to that level. This actually goes down. Let me turn it around. And you'll see over here, this tank goes down, and this is the sub-tank. So this bottom tank, this portion right here, is actually one tank for expansion. This tank here, it goes down, it feeds here, and then in the event of overfill, then it jumps down here and it crosses over. So it's two tanks, but there's actually a bypass built in the event of an emergency. Also, what you'll notice on this side is these bleed screws. So in the event this tank overfills, there's two little overflow vents right here, and we've incorporated those vents into our tank. So again, you'll see our tank has the same little overflow vents. So because our tank is black and you can't see it anymore, what we did is we built the sight gauge into it. So what you do is you open this up all the way. This right here is equivalent to this fill line right here, that fill line. So what we're going to do now is we're going to move this out of the way. And now I'm going to get a funnel, and I'm going to fill this up until this barely starts to bleed fluid. So I'm going to use GM coolant, the same stuff that came out. Right now, this is what I actually took out of the its stock, so I'm going to fill that back up. So don't be fooled by the bottle, because it's actually just the residual that I pulled out. Okay, so there you go. Now what we do is we're gonna lock this down. And you really, it's kind of a set it and forget it. You'll never have to worry about it again. So now the bottom tank is filled to the proper level. Next thing I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna transfer the cap from the existing tank over to the new tank. And just snap it in place. And it's easy to access. Once I get the hose on there, I'll spin this around. But right now, I'm going to leave it sideways. So now we're going to take this whole subassembly, we're going to go back to the car, and we're going to install it. Okay, so we're back now, and now we're going to reinstall the tank. And it just drops straight back in the same way the other one came out. Straight down. That's it. You can already see how much better it looks. I'm gonna put that harness back on, the one that I pulled off. I'm gonna take the back hose now. I'm gonna push that hose on. I'm gonna push the front hose on. And we're basically done. Now all I gotta do is move the clamp back, and fill the coolant level, and we'll be done. Just hide that a little more. This back one takes a little more thinking. It's a little more beefy. Next thing we're going to do is, for the purpose of this video, we actually supply you with a cap. We designed a special cap to go on these, but by the time you guys start purchasing these round two, we're actually going to go back and use the OE cap. Originally, I had wanted to use something that was a little higher pressure, but essentially now they're all the same, so we're going to go back to the cap. But if your kit included a cap, then that means we used our specific threaded neck. If you didn't get a cap in your kit, there'll be an instruction to tell you just to use the OE cap. But either way, we'll give you a sticker that goes on there that basically tells you what the pressure should be. And now with this, we're gonna fill it up. Well, that's a little bit too much. So. That's nice. Don't do this at home. that fire engine threw me off. We're gonna leave that in the video, so years from now when we look back, we can all laugh. But. And to prove to you guys that we're not going to photo, we're not going to edit any of that out, I'll leave that in. Just don't do the same thing I did. Because the system was not under pressure when we started, we know that the radiator is essentially already full. And this expansion tank is the highest point of the engine. So by having the fluid right to the top, you're doing exactly what you need to do. The only thing left for us to do here now is put the shock tower brace back on. There's really no reason to videotape that. So I'm going to put this in place. And essentially I'm going to tell you guys thank you very much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed my mistakes. It shows I'm human. And thank you very much.